You know, I think the governors of New York and New Jersey particularly ought to be removed from office. I think they ought to be quarantined and separated from public policy because, you know, most of the deaths in those communities, the ones that you can link not to sort of Mother Nature and the terrible part of this disease, were public policy decisions.
And when this happened, I want to switch topics over to coronavirus a little bit. When this happened, it was health experts and the people who were condemning the anti-lockdown protesters and saying we needed to stay shut down had very little issue with the people taking to the streets, rioting, looting, being shoulder to shoulder, not wearing masks properly. In fact, we saw some health experts and officials say that social justice was more important than the coronavirus pandemic. What did you think about that?
You even had experts that were saying, well, you can't catch it. You know, if you're rioting for a good cause, you can't catch it. Now, if you're rioting or protesting the lockdown and you're protesting your Democrat governor who won't let you go to the store, won't let you outside, then you can catch it. It's just this bizarre notion that certain things. But I think the one thing we did find from this is we had all these people in the streets and we still didn't get a surge. So maybe we do need to end the lockdown and let people get out. And peaceful protest, I'm all for. I'm all for the First Amendment. And, you know, I think there are legitimate things to complain about in our criminal justice system. But I have absolutely no tolerance. And actually, it hurts the movement. You know, it makes people more hardened in their position when they see the rioting, because they're like, these people have no point. If you're going to riot and tear down statues and throw bottles through windows and burn businesses, you know, it takes away from the whole argument, the legitimate argument over criminal justice reform. And really, I think the rioting has set us back a good decade. I think race relations actually have been improving over the last 100 to 200 years. Every decade it's been better. There's actually, and be careful saying this, but there's actually less racism and less prejudice than there's ever been. I'm almost 60 years old. Every decade of my life, there has been less racism and less discrimination. There's more intermarriage between the races. There's more intermarriage between people of different religions and cultures than there's ever been. In corporate America, you are hard pressed to find a publicly traded company that's been accused of racism. People bend over backwards for diversity in a private way, and I'm all for that. But to make it out that the world's coming to an end and everybody hates everybody is completely inaccurate. And it's setting back race relations because there isn't this hatred. I don't meet anybody. I haven't met anybody in my entire adult life who makes their decisions based on race and in a hateful way. I don't know any of those people. So I don't understand why we have to now say that everything is applied to race, when in reality, there are a lot of policy things need to change. We need to work together. But if we make it all about race, I think the hatred gets worse and the policy decisions get moved to the back burner.
And my final question is that the governors of New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut are ordering a mandatory 14-day quarantine on visitors. Is this something that you think that other states should consider? Do you think this is necessary?
You know, I think the governors of New York and New Jersey particularly ought to be removed from office. I think they ought to be quarantined and separated from public policy because, you know, most of the deaths in those communities, the ones that you can link not to sort of Mother Nature and the terrible part of this disease, were public policy decisions. So the left-wing media loves to, you know, laud Cuomo and Murphy from New Jersey about this. Tens of thousands of people died because of their decision. And I know they're human, but everybody's bragging about how great they are at decision-making. They sent people back to the nursing homes who were positive with this disease. It was a terrible mistake. And really, they should be ridden out of office, impeached, never allowed to make public decision-making again because of so many deaths. And people need to wake up to that. In my state, we haven't had the number of deaths, but we have 700,000 people out of work because we've got a drunk with power governor who keeps the economy shut down. And now you have to apply and ask him for permission to run your business. And then you have to run it according to his edicts. This is, you know, sort of the argument against a command economy. We never wanted to let all the decisions be made by a Politburo or a Congress or one individual, because if that individual makes a mistake, it has ramifications throughout the economy. It's the same way with the experts. We shouldn't let Fauci be the end all on everything, because what if he's wrong? What if he's gone to overkill about keeping the schools closed? Or maybe he's overzealous about not playing baseball in October, which has no scientific basis in anything. We can't let this happen. So we really have to be careful about letting too much power gravitate to one person. We've always believed that, but it's even more important now in the middle of this pandemic.
Well, I was a little confused. I'm like, how do you even enforce that? They're like, well, we're going to give you fines, starting with like 5,000 up to, I don't know, thousands and thousands of dollars. But how are they going to track you down? They were saying they were going to work with the airlines, possibly. Do you have any idea how that would be enforced?
Well, the interesting thing is, like in my state, our governor has been struck down 3 times. Most recently, he said that you cannot gather together in the form of a protest to protest the lockdown. Now, apparently you can if you're protesting against the police, but you cannot, or statues, but you cannot gather if you're protesting against the lockdown. But guess what? The federal court struck him down. They struck him down on that. They struck him down on a travel ban. And they also struck him down on preventing people going to church. Now, whether or not this new quarantine rule up there preventing other people from coming, guess what? The rest of us all got this from New York, if you want to know the truth. Most of the sources of the infection came in from both China and Italy in Europe in February. I think it was over 2 million international travelers came into New York. And guess what? Some of those people then spread it to the rest of the United States. And we can't be in this blame game where, you know, we blame New York. But it's a little ironic that New York now wants to keep other people from coming back in when most of us can get to the ground zero patient being actually from New York City.
Well, Senator, we're going to leave it here. Thank you so much for spending time with us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.